Hi, I'm Abba Shapiro, and welcome to Premiere Pro in under 5 minutes. Today we're going to look at a couple of effects in the effects panel that can really help you fine-tune your luminance adjustments on a clip. Now, I really like this clip. It's actually I'll call it a skylapse. It's a time lapse of the stars and a meteor shower. And it's real pretty, but I really want to be able to work with my black and white elements. And I could do that over in the Lumetri color panel, but there's a couple of effects that can really take me to the next level. And those two are shadow and highlights adjustments. So let me go ahead and I'm going to rearrange my screen just a little bit so that you can work better. Now, we have our current workspace, but I want to rip the effects control tab off my current panel and just bring it over here to the right. And now, if I want, I can look at my scopes, my effects controls, which I'll be using for these two effects, as well as my final image. And let me just move this over a little bit so we're giving them all equal weight. If I wanted to, I could even go ahead and close my Lumetri color panel. Now that we have all of this real estate, let's go ahead and use the shadows and highlights effect. You'll notice as soon as I drop the shadow and highlight effect onto the clip, it raises the luminance values, and this is actually one of my favorite effects to use on a clip because I can immediately with one effect go ahead and get the shot almost where I want it to be. Now, to fine tune it, I'm going to open up a second effect, and that effect is the Luma Corrector. So I'm going to drop the Luma Corrector on the clip and nothing will appear to happen, but watch when we go to the scopes, the fine control you have on your image. Now with the scopes, I'm only going to work with my waveform, so let's close that vector scope, and now I can really fine tune what's happening in my image. The first effect that I put on, shadow and highlight, it has a default which is checked, and a lot of times that works, but if you want to tweak it a little bit, go ahead, click off auto amounts, and now you'll have sliders that you can work with that will control just the shadow amount and the highlight amount, and you can see as I tweak these that my scope changes to where not only does my image look good to the eye, but it also looks good in the scopes. So I'm going to go ahead and work with my shadows, and I want them to be nice and deep, and there's even fine controls here if you look under more options. But we're going to actually move on to the next effect that I put on that I really like, and I'm going to close the shadow and highlight so you can see all the options I have under Luma Corrector. And you'll see there's brightness, there's contrast, contrast level, and so on. And I can go ahead and create a split view. I'm going to turn that on. And this is nice because I can see my before and my after. So I'm going to go ahead and turn on split view. It's right here below composite and above horizontal. And I don't want it horizontal, I want it vertical. And now as I make changes, I'll be able to see what the before and the after were like, including the before and the after on my scopes. Now, at first blush, this looks okay, but this is where it really gets cool. You'll notice that I have a choice of working with the master or the entire clip, but if I click on master, I have choices to work with my highlights, midtones, and shadows. So if I go ahead and select my highlights, now when I work with brightness and gamma and pedestal being your black levels, it only will work in the highlights area. So I'm not affecting my blacks or mids at all, yet I have all of these controls to fine tune in that one area. So as you see, when I work with brightness, it's really only working with the upper part, and there's only nuance here. So let's go ahead and jump down to shadows, and now I'm working with the brightness of just my shadows. And you'll see as I move that adjustment left and right, it doesn't affect the luminance values of my mid or my highlight range. It really defines a certain section. And that's where this is really nice because I can really control nuance with this, bring down just my shadows where I want without affecting either my midtones or my highlights unless I choose to by selecting highlights or midtones instead of master. So these are two great effects that you can work with that really let you build the luminance values that you want on your clip.